In 1968, the first People's Mercedes was launched. Stroke 8, named in reference to its debut year, was an entirely new concept. The cars, internally called W114 and 115, won the hearts of the customers, and about 2 million units left the assembly line, as much as the total Mercedes-Benz production sum from 1945 until 1968. The plain body shape and the technical innovations responded to the customers' needs. The chassis was noticeably restructured. Additionally, Stroke 8 was supplied with a new rear axle, dubbed the Diagonal Swing Axle, which allowed safe road handling. Regarding safety, W114 and 115 were manufactured with 4-disc brakes, today a worldwide standard. The original model variations of the range included 6 types, from the 200D with a 55 horsepower 4-cylinder diesel engine to the 250 with a 130 horsepower 6-cylinder carburetor engine. The superior type 250 was easily distinguishable by its outer appearance. It was the only one with a double bar front bumper. All diesel and gasoline fueled 4-cylinders were assigned to the 115 series and all 6-cylinders to the 114 series. The interior of this small Mercedes was plain but enriched with numerous novelties, attributing to a pleasant drive, like the center console. During the 1973 revamping, the safety of W114 and 115 was enhanced. The range featured a number of details previously introduced with the SL and SLC types and the S-Class. Interior controlled wing mirrors, dirt repellent decorative screens at the A-pillars in order to keep the side windows clean in bad weather, molded dirt repellent rear lights, and drip molding at the back window. From March 1973 on, headrests and automatic seat belts in the front became standard in the series provisions. During development, new trials in active and passive safety were performed. Another novelty was wipers on the front lights. And already then, Mercedes-Benz began testing a phenomenal invention, the airbag. The improved models had also been visually adapted to fit the appearance of the S-Class. The radiator grille was lower and wider. The side ventipanes were removed. The license plate Orifix was attached onto instead of below the bumper. And the trunk handle altered. Also, the front end edge matched its older brother's outfit. Types 250 to 280E lost their front double bumpers, just like the coupe models. The visually upgraded types 280 and 280E were the only sedans of the model range that kept the rear bumper. In the course of a makeover in autumn 1973, 2 new 4-cylinder engines were installed. Type 240D was the top of the diesel model range, while Type 230.4 replaced the 220. The 4 in the type designation of the new 230 was necessary to avoid confusion with the original 230, which additionally had a 6-cylinder motor and was still available as Type 230.6. In July 1974, the model range was once more enhanced. Type 240D 3.0 was introduced to the world as the first 5-cylinder diesel, whose engine could produce 80 horsepower. in the context of the time, an extraordinary achievement. Apart from the Stroke 8 sedans, a coupe variant was introduced, a complete novelty in the mid-range. First serialized were types 250C and 250CE, followed by types 280C and 280CE. The Stroke 8 coupes entered the market with the superior engine of the six-cylinder sedans. Design and accessories were first matched to the sedans, and in the 70s, they corresponded more and more with that of its older brother, the SLC Coupe. In January 1976, the successors of Series 114 and 115 appeared on the stage. Series 123, which was already being manufactured. Production of the Stroke 8 types did not stop immediately, but was continued until December 1976, so that both series were produced in unison for about a year. Types 250 to 280E and the coupes were all discontinued separately between June and September 1976. To date, the W114 and W115 still exhibit consistent high-quality workmanship, even after so many years. A wear and tear car for daily use that has retained its allure for fans and collectors all over the world. In spring 1971, Mercedes-Benz premiered a sports car with an entirely new technical makeup, the 350 SL. This youngest SL generation marked the turn from an uncompromising hard sports car to a high-performance luxury roadster. A timeless body outline combined with typical Mercedes-Benz virtues made it a genuine sales hit, until today. The internally called R107 stayed true to the traditional concept of the whole range. As a two-seater with convertible and removable hardtop, the new one hardly had anything in common with its predecessor, the Pagoda SL that was built until 1968. The front and rear wheel suspension of the 1972 released S-Class Range 116 derived from its stylistic forerunner, the now legendary Stroke 8. The motor was a tested and proven V8 engine taken from the sedans, coupes and cabriolets of type 280 3.5. From 1973 on, a 4.5 liter V8 engine was also available. The interior was furnished with an eye to safety and appeared factual and functional. The ergonomic seat position supported a healthy posture. The SL was also a role model in regards to passive safety. The fuel tank was for the first time installed above the rear axle and thus protected from collision. Additional impact protection was provided by a retractable steering column and padded upholstery with adjustable switches. In 1973, the SL was re-equipped with a four-gear automatic transmission and the light metal alloy engine of the S-Class. As reaction to the worldwide oil crisis in the previous year, Mercedes-Benz launched the fuel-efficient 280 SL. For the first time in the history of the SL type range, three vehicles with three different engines were available. New type designations were introduced in 1980. The 350 SL became the 380 SL. The 450 SL was succeeded by a new type, the 500 SL, which was recognizable by its rubber rear spoiler. Also in 1985, finally a 3-liter six-cylinder engine was premiered and gave rise to a new roadster with the magical 300 SL designation. In August of 89, the last SL of the type R107 rolled off the assembly line after over 8 years of production, which was an unsurpassed record in itself. No other passenger car from the house of Mercedes-Benz was manufactured for such a long time. All in all, 237,287 vehicles were built. In 1972, a new product line started under the internal code C107. The SLC, closest relative to the SL. Apart from the coupe's hardtop, both variants were identical down to the inner door shell. The lengthened wheelbase allowed for four seats. Other novelties lay in the technical makeup.
Das sichere Zweikreis Servo Bremssystem mit vorderen innenbelüfteten Scheibenbremsen. Das spurstabile Fahrwerk, hinten die Mercedes-Benz Diagonalpendelachse, sind Beiträge zur aktiven Sicherheit. Das Herz des 350 SLC, der 3,5 Liter V8 Motor mit elektronisch gesteuerter Einspritzung, Transistorzündung und oben liegenden Nockenwelle. Dieses 200 PS starke Aggregat beschleunigt das Coupé in 8,8 Sekunden von 0 auf 100 Stundenkilometer.
In April 1973, a new V8 engine became available that specified an enhanced cylinder capacity of 4.5 liters and generated 225 horsepower. The classy interior combined the comfort and spaciousness of a saloon with the sporty character of the SL Roadster. For passengers in the rear seats, the SLC was equally suitable for travel. As with the Roadster, the coupe was bestowed with various safety measures, such as the safety steering unit, which heightened impact protection. The top model of the range debuted in 1977, the 450 SLC 5.0, characterized by a new light metal alloy engine and reduced weight. Prominent identifying features included a discrete front spoiler, a black plastic rear spoiler, and the gray finish under the body side molding. In 1980, the coupe was technically updated to the S-Class level, with an optimized engine performance and refurbished interior. The type designation was modified accordingly. The 450 SLC 5.0 became the 500 SLC. The 380 SLC replaced the 350 SLC. The SLC proved its sport merits at the famous Bandama Rally at the Ivory Coast in Africa. In December, the Mercedes team clutched a four-time victory in the 450 SLC 5.0. In 1981, about 1.5 years after the last makeover, the coupes of the 107 series had to make way for a new variant. In a 10-year production span, a total of 62,888 units were produced, sought-after collector's cars to this day. In 1976, Mercedes-Benz unveiled a whole new generation of mid-range sedans to the public in Bandol, south of France. No less than 9 different gasoline and diesel variations were heir to the popular and robust Stroke 8. Comfort and driving performance benefited from the lengthening of wheelbase and front wheel track.
Der Fahrer nimmt wahr, verarbeitet, entscheidet, handelt.
Technically, the new model range was styled after the S-Class, which had been produced for 3 years. It was correspondingly provided with a semi-trailing arm rear axle and a double wishbone front wheel suspension.
Fahrwerk und Lenkung signalisieren den Grenzwert der Haftung. Mit erstklassiger Technik lassen sich auch schwierige Situationen meistern.
Irgendwann geht da jedes Auto weg. Unseres soll es später tun.
A striking design feature was the big round double headlights. The top models 280 and 280E were equipped with rectangular broadband halogen lights. At the beginning of production, the 123 sedan came with a 2-liter diesel engine, providing 55 horsepower, and a high-performance 2.8-liter fuel injection producing 185 horsepower. Two new gasoline engines were added, a 2-liter carburetor engine with 109 horsepower, and a fuel injection with an output of 136 horsepower. The interior was available with a wide variety of accessories and allowed a choice based on individual taste and budget. For instance, the seat upholstery came in different colors and fabrics, like velour, MB-Tex, or leather. Safety was enhanced with an improved safety cage and a reinforced top frame structure. The latest safety development was the safety steering column, which connected steering aggregate and steering column jacket by a corrugated pipe so that the column was prevented from penetrating the interior.
Mit Gurt vervielfacht sich die Überlebenschance bei einem Unfall. Selbst der stärkste Mann der Welt könnte sich bestenfalls gegen einen Frontalaufprall von 15 Kilometern pro Stunde wehren. 15 Kilometer pro Stunde. Nicht mehr. Frontalaufprall mit 50 Kilometern Geschwindigkeit und Versuch mit dem Airbag, dem Luftsack.
It was available for an extra charge of a lavish 1,579 marks. The first makeover in 1977 resulted in three body variants. A coupe, another sedan with longer wheelbase, and an independent variation of the T. In 1978, the output of the 280E was boosted to 185 horsepower, while the 240D produced 72 horsepower. A year later, the 200D achieved 5 horsepower more. The 220D was abandoned, and the engines of the 300D and the 250 were substantially modified. In 1980, a 2-liter carburetor engine and a 136 horsepower fuel injection replaced the season forerunners. The additional makeover of 1982 was beneficial for all models of the range. Noteworthy in this context was the series-produced servo steering. Prominent features of the new 123s were the rectangular headlights. Taxi drivers especially profited from the numerous improvements in the safety area.
Und jetzt auch noch diese beiden Typen. Wo fahren die denn hin? Ach, oh Backe, zum alten Güterbahnhof. Was versteckt er bloß unter seiner Jacke? Ein Glück, dass ich sie in meinem Tandemspiegel beobachten kann. Und wenn es hart auf hart geht, habe ich ja immer noch meine Alarmanlage.
Der Druck auf einen individuell zu installierenden Knopf setzt auch während der Fahrt das Alarmsystem in Betrieb.
The 123s also obtained honors in sports with hard endurance grinding rallies. Almost 2.7 million vehicles left the assembly line by the end of the range in 1985.
Na, Chef, wo brennst denn?
Ja.
Reparatur?
Nein.
Große Inspektion? Nein. Auch nicht. Verliert Öl?
Nein.
Da läuft unruhig?
Nein.
Nein, auch nicht.
Tut mir leid, dem Wagen fehlt nichts.
Na, und was wollen Sie denn hier?
Die Kinder müssen mal.
Ah, die Kinder müssen mal. Die Kinder müssen mal.
In 1979, Mercedes-Benz for the first time introduced its own station wagon, listed under T for Transport and Tourism. The third body variant, called T Model, made the station wagon a society vehicle, conquering a new class of customers. The stunning success caused waiting lists of up to 3 years, with demand outstripping supply. In technical and stylistical terms, the T model was obviously derived from the 123 sedan, with only the rear as a distinguishing feature.
Der Trickfilm veranschaulicht nochmal, wie vielseitig sich der Mercedes T für Passagiere und Zuladung verwandeln lässt. Durchgehende Sitzbank im Fond. Rest Laderaum. Auf Wunsch Kindersitzbank zusätzlich. Plus Kopfstützen, beidseitig nutzbar. Vorn Sitzbank hoch, Lehne runtergeklappt, Laderaum größer. Sitzbank raus, Laderaum noch größer. Beifahrersitz nach vorn, Lehne zurück, durchgehender Gepäckraum bis zum Armaturenbrett. Auf Wunsch im Vorn geteilte Sitze. Ein breiterer Zweidrittel, ein schmalerer Eindrittelsitz. Mit Kindersitzbank, Raum für 6 bis 7 Personen. Kindersitzbank mit 2 Griffen voll versenkt. Zweidrittel Vornsitz umgelegt, Raum für 3 Personen und für noch mehr Gepäck. Sitzbank raus und Laderaum nochmal vergrößert. Andersherum. Ein Drittelsitz geklappt, gibt Platz für 4 Personen. Beifahrer Rücklehne herunter, 3 Personen und langes Ladegut sind kein Problem. Platz für 2, mehr Raum für Ladung. Und so verschenkt der Fahrer keinen Zentimeter Laderaum.
Initially, the model range included the diesel 240 TD. The gasoline models 230T and 250T, and the top model 280TE. This last one stuck out visually with rectangular broadband lights and a chromed air vent grille in front of the windshield. The T model's interior exuded the laid-back atmosphere of a sedan. Limited storage space due to the slanted rear was more than compensated for by the overall stunning visual appearance. In safety concerns, the 123 model family was also ahead of its time. A restructured passenger car and the technically advanced safety steering column provided the best possible passenger protection. The station wagons also benefited from the updated sedan engines. In September 1978, the output of the 240 TD was pushed to 72 horsepower. From 1979 on, the performances of the 300 TD's 5-cylinder engine and the 6-cylinder carburetor engine of the 250T were heightened. And another year later, the type range was rounded off with the newly introduced 4-cylinders 230 TE and 200T. A new top model debuted in 1980, the 300 TD turbo diesel, the first German Mercedes passenger car with a turbo engine. From 1982 on, all models of the range left the assembly line with upgraded interior and series produced servo steering. The first generation of T models was produced for almost 8 years. Until the end of the range in 1986, 199,517 units had been produced and became the trendsetter in the genre of lifestyle station wagons, which are quite popular today.
Als Autofahrer sind Sie nicht immer derselbe. Schließlich nutzen Sie Ihr Auto nicht nur beruflich, sondern auch in der Freizeit. Vielleicht segeln Sie gerne oder Ihr Hobby sind Heimwerkerarbeiten. Wenn Sie eine Familie haben, fahren Sie sicherlich gern mit den Kindern ins Grüne. Oder Sie besitzen eigenes Grün, einen eigenen Garten. Vielleicht fahren Sie mit dem eigenen Wagen in Urlaub, im Sommer oder im Winter. Oder Sie wollen Ihre Frau zum Essen ausführen. Dann sollte Ihr Auto nicht weniger vielseitig sein als Sie. Sollte Ihnen in der Freizeit und im Beruf zur Seite stehen.
In 1977, Mercedes-Benz brought yet another variation of the 123 series into being. The coupes 230C, 280C, and 280CE took over from the Stroke 8 coupes. The elegant 123 coupes surprised contemporaries with a sleek profile. Lavish chrome fittings underlined the prominent character of the coupe, which was built without B-pillars. The coupe's mechanical makeup was similar to that of the sedans. Maneuverability was improved by a semi-trailing arm rear axle, plus a double wishbone suspension in the front. The unique style of the two-door version was owed to the 85 millimeter shorter wheelbase. The coupe's engines correlated one-to-one with the sedan specifications. A wide selection of special accessories promised an individualized interior according to taste and pocketbook. Upholstery came in different colors and in textile or leather. Great strides were made regarding the safety of the new coupe range. Noteworthy steps included an improved safety cage with stiffened top frame structure, high-strength roof pillar, and reinforced doors. In 1978, the coupes underwent their first overhaul. Together with the sedans, the horsepower of the 2.8-liter fuel injection engine now measured 185. In 1980, the 230C received a completely new engine, which transformed it into a 136 horsepower strong CE. Remarkably, by request, the types 230CE and 280CE were, even in 1982, available with ABS. And surprise, an airbag. Series production of the 123 coupes ended in August 1985. After 99,884 units came into being. Well-preserved models in mint condition are already traded for aficionado prices today. Speaking of aficionados, one was acting legend Gerd Fürbe.
Ah, wissen Sie, beim Autowaschen, da kommt man seinem Auto doch am nächsten. Da sieht man mal so richtig, was man für ein Prachtstück hat. Übrigens, meine Freunde, die fahren auch solche Waschstücke. Wissen Sie warum? Die brauchen ein sicheres Auto mit viel Fahrkomfort.
In September 1972, Mercedes-Benz debuted a new upper-range generation as successor of Series 108 and 109. It was, for the first time, officially named the Mercedes-Benz S-Class, internally W116. In this first S-Class, a remarkable technical innovation was now serially included: double wishbone front suspension that tremendously improved performance. The rear wheel suspension had already proved itself in the Stroke 8 types. The model range initially included types 280S, 280SE, and 350SE. Half a year later, the type 450SE was released, with a greater cylinder capacity, simultaneously with the 100mm longer 450SEL. After 1973, the lengthened version was additionally available as 350SEL, and a year later as 280SEL. The safety dashboard and the well-proportioned interior was strongly padded. Moreover, flexible switches and levers, along with the inclusion of a four-spoke safety steering wheel with impact improver, provided the highest possible passenger protection. Also, in regard to passive safety, the S-Class exemplified the state of the art. The fuel tank was not at the immediate rear anymore, but above the rear axle, safe from collision. And the most important improvement compared to its predecessor, a safety cage with stiffened top frame structure and high-strength roof pillars and door posts. In May 1975, a new S-Class top model was released, the Type 450 SEL 6.9. With a cubic capacity of nearly 7 liters, the 6.9 was considered a true torque wonder. Its driving performance even outdid some of the super sports cars of its time. The hitherto unused hydropneumatic suspension with level control system offered driving comfort of the highest degree. In a class of their own, the S-Class sedans were bestowed with the newly developed anti-lock brake system ABS. Even when slamming the brakes, ABS assures steering capability. What is today a worldwide standard, even in compact cars, was in 1978 a real sensation. In 1979, Mercedes-Benz issued the follow-ups into the 126 series. Production of the 116s did continue on for a while, though, until September 1980, when the last of the 473,035 units left the Sindelfingen facilities. In 1979, a new generation of the Mercedes-Benz S-Class took over from the model range 116. Initially, it included 7 types. In 1981, a coupe version supplemented the choice. The new S-Class of range 126 symbolized the changing spirit of automobile production and clearly showed that the often baroque body styles of the 70s were finally over. Despite initial criticism, the 126s turned out to be a successful endeavor. Fuel-saving measures were significant in these new upper-range models. This was accomplished by the use of lightweight materials, plus a body that was optimized in the wind tunnel. 2 variants were for sale, the regular saloon and a long version with a lengthened wheelbase of 140 millimeters. The engine selection of the S-Class went from a 2.8-liter six-cylinder carburetor, output 156 horsepower, to a 5-liter V8 light metal engine with fuel injection, boosted to 240 horsepower. In line with the Mercedes-Benz energy concept to reduce fuel consumption and emissions, both V8 engines were respecified in 1981. For the first time, automatic seat adjustment was incorporated into a Mercedes-Benz passenger car. The plush, spacious interior permitted comfortable travel in all seats. Seat belts were adjustable for all sizes. A new age of passive safety commenced in 1981. The first airbag was fitted into the S-Class. Together with a seatbelt preload device and ABS, they soon were part of the standard series equipment.
Das ist für mich der Gipfel der Sicherheit. Bei einem Frontalaufprall macht es pft, und in 30 Millisekunden bläst es sich auf.
In 1985, Mercedes-Benz introduced a re-engineered type program. Aside from small visual modifications, the engines were the foreground. Type 420 SE replaced the former 380 SE. A V8 204 horsepower engine with catalytic converter was incorporated into the SEC Coupe and the SL Roadster. The most dazzling novelty of the year was undoubtedly the 560 SEL. Its 272 horsepower 8-cylinder made it the strongest of Mercedes-Benz's mass-produced passenger cars. In 1986, a 3-way catalytic converter became commonplace. The last units of the 126 S-Class saloons left the Sindelfingen line in autumn 1991. In the company's history to date, this type was the most successful in the upper range. A total of 818,036 cars were manufactured. The 126 series fostered its own coupe variations in September 1981. Types 380 SEC and 500 SEC superseded the old SLC models. The new generation now was based on the S-Class sedans instead of the SL model as before. Only the horizontal radiator grille remained as a visual relic. The elegant and harmonious appearance found instant acclaim. Even today, car aficionados worldwide rank the SEC Coupe among the most beautiful post-war car models. Apart from a few details, the chassis complied with those of the sedans, to which the Coupe also owed its double wishbone axle. And the semi-trailing arm rear axle. The front wheels of the SEC coupes were equipped with floating caliper disc brakes for the first time. Also, the floor pan components were basically taken over from the sedans, but shorter by 85 millimeters. Under the hood, V8 engines were quite potent, as had been proven in the sedans and SLC models. In the course of the Mercedes-Benz energy concept, the engines were modified for the reduction of fuel and emissions. Therefore, fuel consumption of the SEC Coupe was considerably less than that of its predecessor. Interior equipment was also modeled on that of the sedans. For fans of technical comforts, an automatic belt handover was installed as a series standard. The body of the SEC Coupe answered to the latest results in safety research. In contrast to the sedans, the B-pillar was missing, which was compensated for by a strengthened roof frame and reinforced A-pillars. The SEC Coupes were first revised 4 years after their debut in 1985. Aside from a discrete facelift, the restructuring of the engines was significant. A 4.2-liter V8 engine with 245 horsepower was added to the agenda. However, the real sensation was the 560 SEC. This top model revved up to 273 horsepower from a 5-liter cubic capacity. From 1986 on, catalytic converters were standard in all Mercedes-Benz petrol engines. The coupe's standard equipment was also upgraded, plus the appearance was slightly altered. Deep drawn aprons improved road holding at high speed. Moreover, the new models received smooth protective strips and new shock absorbers. In September 1987, output increased variations off all V8 engines were introduced. Almost 10 years after their entrance into the market, production of the SEC Coupes came to a standstill. A total of 74,060 units testified to their select appeal. In February 1979, Mercedes-Benz dared to tread an unfamiliar terrain. Developed in cooperation with the Austrian Steyr Daimler Puch Corporation since 1973, the G model was possibly the most versatile Mercedes-Benz passenger car ever, but above all, cross-country suitable.
The brake is...
The model choice of the G range originally included 4-engine and 5-body variations. Aside from an open car with a short wheelbase, a station wagon and 2 van versions were available. At the beginning of production, the tried and true petrol and diesel engines from Series 123 were used. Over the years, this star-bearing trekking vehicle was modified numerous times, which particularly benefited the engines. In September 1989, a new chapter in the story of the G model was opened with a substantially improved series, internally called 463. This new off-road vehicle impressed many with its modern design and comparably comfortable interior. Technical changes were also noteworthy, such as four-wheel drive, series differential locks, and anti-lock brake systems. Apart from the modified engines of Series 460, two new six-cylinder motors powered the vehicles, a diesel and a gasoline, both with a 3-liter cubic capacity. 1992 saw the market debut of the 136 horsepower 350 GD turbo. On the other end of the spectrum ranked the 240 horsepower type 500 GE V8. Type designations were adapted in 1993. The G was put in front of the three-figure number.
The brake is.
Another new addition was the type G320, generating 210 horsepower. In 1996, the G300 turbo diesel superseded the G350 turbo diesel. In contrast to its predecessor, the new diesel model was issued with a four-valve turbo engine and intercooling. 1997 brought some more substantial revamping. The new Cabriolet was provided with an electro-hydraulic operating soft top. The G320 was bestowed with a newly developed V6 engine. And all models from range 463 were supplied with rear disc brakes. In April 1998, the new top model had its premiere, the G500, with a 300 horsepower V8 engine. Amongst the standard specials were air conditioning and leather upholstery. A simplified version, internally W461, entered the market in 1992. It was essentially derived from the original G model of range 460 and was planned for commercial and public service. The new range also counted the still available 230 GD. Optional bodies were station wagon and van on a longer wheelbase.
The brake is.
In December 2000, the G-Class was overhauled once again. This time, the diesel motors were the beneficiaries and were adapted to the common rail principle. The youngest generation offered two more models, the G320 with a 215 horsepower V6 engine and a V8 gasoline G500 topping 296 horsepower. A five-gear automatic transmission with a modern Tiptronic gear shift mechanism is standard in all variants. The interior was generously upscaled too. A cabrio with electric folding top and station wagons with two or four doors are also obtainable. The G designated cross country, being a genuine classic, secured a fixed place in the type program. Thus, production also continued after the successful introduction of the M-Class. In 2004, Mercedes-Benz celebrated the 25th anniversary of the G-Class.